about Lalit Yadav. Like the fact, Rishabh Pant saying that, like him, like the fact that he showed another gear today. And of course, with his bowling and his batting, geez, I mean, Joy, when he came into this, I think it was the last game or the game before, when he came in, you were like, oh yeah, he's new, he's, you know, unknown commodity, this Delhi settled. Geez, now it looks like he's not giving his spot up for sure.
No, no, absolutely. I just love it. I love the fact that these new guys, whoever's getting their chance, is grabbing onto it with both hands. Avesh Khan, you know, picked over him. Ishan might have had a niggle, but he was definitely picked over Umesh. Definitely picked over him. And he goes and he grabs his chance with both hands. Lalit Yadav gets his opportunity. Shreyas Iyer is not there. And he's going to say, I don't care. This is my opportunity. One season I have to make this count. I'm going to make this really count. And Lalit Yadav has had a fairly decent domestic. Mursaq Ali and all, he's been phenomenal. Absolutely phenomenal.
Just to take off on what Joy is saying, you judge a side by how well the players coming in start to play. That's where Mumbai has been really good over the years. You know, Bumrah comes in 6-7 years ago. Krunal comes in. Now look what's happening this round. Amit Mishra comes in, player of the match today. Understandable. I thought Lalit Yadav, but Amit Mishra, but he comes in, player of the match. Lalit Yadav comes in, he's given number 4. Can you imagine a Ponting and a Pant telling him, beta, we back you at number 4. So, but he has delivered. That means, and look what Rishabh says. He's a great Indian player we are trying to groom. Okay, but they're trying to groom him. But he has come in and delivered. Avesh Khan, he has come in and delivered. Something right is happening in that side. There's a reason they finished third and second in two successive years. Something right is happening there. Shikhar Dhawan, he comes to Delhi, his strike rate goes up from 120 to 140. I know today, young Prithvi Shaw didn't do well, but he's given you 2 innings already out of 4. He's given you 32 out of 17. He's given you a big thing. Something is happening in that Delhi side that these players are all doing well.
Can I tell you, I had a chat with Ishan Sharma. Actually, I almost just bumped into him last year. This was before the last year. Well, the world was still open. So it's over a year ago. And he said something very interesting. He said, I love this Delhi dressing room. He said, out of all the dressing rooms I've been in, and he's been in quite a few, right? He says, the mahal here, he says, this is the chillest, most relaxed and most secure dressing room. And I think that one word really struck with me, the lack of insecurity. That's what, I don't know, Joy, were you guys, was this ever kind of one of those intangible markers that you had that
John was coach, yeah.
Well, not then. Probably not at that time.
No, but when Gambhir was coach, when Gambhir was captain, yeah, Joy, you know that better, yeah.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I think it makes such a difference just to know. And look, different teams are chill in different ways. So, for example, Gambhir cannot be chill in a way of, you know, he's going to be funny. But yeah. Gambhir is he can make you feel secure. He can say, it doesn't matter. I'm going to back you no matter what. So, there are different ways of doing it. You know, Dhoni will do it, you know, silently. Dhoni will not even bother about team meetings. The real meetings will be in his room where all the kids are sitting around and having chat till 4 o'clock in the morning. So, every good team finds a different way to succeed. They find different ways to get together as a team. And this Delhi team probably has done it in a more relaxed way. Because I think what they've got is, their coach is a very youthful, you know, he's played the IPL and he's played not so long back, you know, he's played in 2013. So he's young, he's like one of the players and he is very, in that way, very forward looking, very youthful. I think he brings that energy to the dressing room. And you'll know,
I've actually, in 2019, they had this thing called the DC Awards, right? Which was just a complete fun awards. And they called me for that. I went to host it. And it was just absolutely rubbish, silly awards. That all it was a team bonding activity. The awards were best singer in the shower, best who's late to the bus. And, you know, it was just absolutely these rubbish awards.
To host it.
Yeah, which is why they call me, because they can only call me for rubbish award shows, right? And I remember Ricky Ponting. No, it's not a joke. That's my business motto, sir. but Ricky Ponting, I remember meeting him before the show and I said, should we do a little bit of a roast? And should we have... He says, start with me. He says, I want you to start with me. Roast me first so that everybody else becomes super chill and understands what the tone of the evening is. It's like, you know, let's just come out and hit, you know, 2-3 fours in the first over so everybody knows how to bat on this surface. And that's exactly what he did. And that's what happened right through the thing. And he came back and then he passed it on where he got the rest of his support staff. And then he was taking the mickey out of them. And then everybody just joined into the gang, and you could just tell that this is a team where no one's looking over their shoulder. No one's thinking, oh, is that below the belt? Is that they're just having fun, having a laugh, and that's how. And you're so right about Ricky Ponting kind of leading the charge from there. I know sometimes there's a lot of debate about, are the coaches getting too much credit? Are they not getting enough credit? But there is one thing, when you've got a senior player and a player of legendary status like Ricky Ponting, one who's really seen the game for a long time, and a lot of these kids have seen him, perhaps idolized him growing up, even whether you give him the entire credit or not, you can give him credit for setting the mood, Harsha, for setting the tone.
You made three valid points, three genuinely valid points. That's in that monologue. Yeah, even Wilson will agree. Just ask him, Wilson, okay. No, the reason Ponting would have said, roast me first, is Ponting is a legend. He's an all-time great, yeah. Right? And there's kids looking up Ponting like that, right? Ponting. If Ponting is willing to get it done, okay, yeah. He's broken the ice there by saying, do me first. Ponting is like Tendulkar, you know, everyone looks up at him. That's the first thing. Second, we did a chat with Ponting the other day in between the game. And we said, you are larger than life in terms of your cricketing achievements. But you've got a young captain who's the leader of the side. And he said, the captain is always the leader. I'm helping Rishabh Pant take the team onto the field, but it is always the captain's team.
Nice.
And I think by doing that, he's telling Rishabh, listen, you've got to grow too. I will help you grow. You know, I will help you grow. But finally, it is your side. And when he was in Mumbai, some of the younger players were so much in awe. And you talk to people on the circuit that about Ponting, and they all have good things to say about him. So there must be something about him. I'm not saying all the credit goes to the coach, because eventually the players have to play well. Yeah. He can tell Shikhar, look, I think you need to move your strike rate from 120 to 135. But finally, Shikhar still has to do it.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
The players respond. So he's got a part of the credit, but the mahal that you talked about is so important.